So SmackDown is moving to FS1 next week, and they're going 2.5 hours?
Yeah, 15th and the 29th. They're going 2.5 hours, and Tony Khan has already tweeted. So, I mean, we have a real war here now, because Tony Khan has already tweeted that, you know, he can't wait to beat the A show to go head-to-head and win this coming Friday night. And people are just like, you know, and WWE, I mean, it's like, you know, for FS1, they got a more loaded show than they ever have on Fox. So that tells you that, like, you know, the one thing that is very clear to me from WWE, number one, the fact that they're going long is interesting, because it's not a lock who's winning this Friday. I mean, if I remember, I'd have to look it up, but I think that they were doing 0.27s and 0.28s. And Rampage can do that. They didn't this week. But they can do a number like that if they load up the show. So it's a dogfight. And obviously, you know, they are, you know, they're going to have the King of the Ring and whatever. Well, I mean, it's the King matches, what, Finn Balor and Sami Zayn, which is not going to, I mean, it could be a really good match, but it's not a drawing match. And then Carmella and Zelina Vega, which, whatever, it's probably going to be a 2-minute match. But they are going to have Brock Lesnar live, and that's a big deal. And they're going to have Becky Lynch against Sasha Banks, which is a real big match. You know, they're doing this singles match on SmackDown this coming Friday, and I would expect that match and Brock Lesnar and probably Roman Reigns are going to be on in that last half hour. So they're going to throw the big guns out there. So it's going to be very competitive, and AEW is going to have Punk against Matt Sydal or the Jericho match opening the show. I don't know, you know, because usually they have the big opener, and then the match in the middle will be the Ruby Soho Bunny match, and it's, you know, the Jericho and Hager and Sammy Guevara against Junior Dos Santos and Ethan Page and Scorpio Sky with Masvidal in the corner. So it's going to be there's going to be a winner and a loser. That's on Friday, and I don't know who it's going to be, and which actually makes it very interesting. It would be, I mean, you know, it, no matter what, it's going to be, a lot of people are going to be talking about it, and there will be people making excuses as well. But it's a real life head-to-head, the first time, you know, at this level. You know, obviously there was head-to-heads every single week for, you know, the first couple of years, but never
would. This is all perception for WWE. Obviously, SmackDown on Fox is going to do, you know, twice the 18 to 49 as Rampage on cable.
Absolutely.
So they're just worried about possibly losing when they move stations for 1 week.
Yeah. Yeah. They are. It's a fight, you know? I mean, if Vince had
the same, they're not in the same time slot. They're forcing themselves to go ahead.
They're adding the time slot so they can do it. But that's what Vince would do. You know, I mean, if Vince had his way, he'd add a third hour to SmackDown to go head to head, because then it would, you know, they would win. You know, Fox versus TNT, they'll win. TNT versus FS1 is a dogfight. You know, it really is, and you know, I don't know what's gonna happen. It could go either way. And it'll be very interesting what happens. I mean, WWE has more fans. There's no doubt about it. WWE has a lot more fans, but AEW usually puts on the better show. But that doesn't necessarily mean anything when it comes to ratings, because, you know, ratings is a matter of, you know, things like star power and stuff. But they're also on an unfamiliar station, which doesn't help. I mean, that is an advantage for AEW. They're going to be in their time slot on their station. SmackDown is going to be on a different station, so that hurts. But obviously, the one thing that Vince doesn't want right now, this week, or this Friday. He does not want to lose on Friday. And obviously, because, you know, Brock Lesnar on FS1 and Sasha Banks against Becky Lynch. I mean, that's putting major guns out there. And King of the Ring and Queen whatever, the Queen Tournament.
That stuff might
Queen's Crown.
Hurt the rating.
I know. The tournaments, the thing with the tournament is, in both cases, is it's like, it's going to be really interesting because, you know, AEW is doing a tournament too. They're going to announce the brackets. So I guess maybe Paige isn't getting the title shot at Full Gear and he's going to get the title shot either on TV, which I don't see that. I think that's a pay-per-view match. So maybe they're going to wait until February like I suggested. And they'll go with Danielson. We'll see. If Danielson is in the 8-man tournament, then Danielson should win. Any other result at that point would be, I think, the wrong result. So, because, you know, but we'll see who's in that tournament. It's because they're doing a tournament that I think starts, they're announcing the brackets either Friday night or Saturday night. I haven't watched AEW, but I mean, I know they are. And then, so then the tournament's probably either starting Saturday or the next week. And I can see why they're doing this because, you know, with Dynamite being on Saturdays, it's going to be tough, obviously, for numbers because it's an unfamiliar night. So I think that that's probably why you're going to be running this tournament for the title shot because, again, you're going to want, you know, a better than usual show because you're in, you know, you're not in that familiar time slot. So this month's going to be very interesting because FS1's going to have another date on the 29th and AEW's going to be on Saturday, so they're not going to be doing a million viewers. You know, maybe they will, but I don't think so. They're going to, you know, and WWE's, you know, been loading up everything every week because, you know, it's WWE and they're competitive. And I mean, anyone who thinks, and some people do, that when they, you know, that WWE doesn't care about AEW, it's like, this is another example. And it shouldn't surprise any. I saw people surprised. And it's like, it shouldn't surprise anyone. And that's part of the business. There's nothing wrong or immoral or illegal about it. That's the wrestling business. And that's how Vince plays. And it's how he's always played. He's played that way since, you know, 1982.
So if you look at the last 5 weeks, Rampage is doing about a 0.28 if you average the last 5 weeks. So they're going to have to do a little bit bigger than that, you would think, to beat SmackDown next week. And then Tony Khan's tweet, I'll read it here. He said, I saw you're doing a half hour head to head with us. I can't wait to finally beat your main show head to head. It's been a long time coming. See you next Friday for AEW Rampage on AEW on TNT.
Yeah.
That's
I saw that and it was just like, you know, I mean, one of the things, and they had the Variety article and everything. One of the things strategically that AEW is playing, at least to me, and they haven't told me this, I'm just watching this from afar, is now that they're at this level, they want the story to be, look how competitive we are with WWE. And, you know, like, you know, Variety had the big story. And the story wasn't even necessarily, like, if you read the story, especially because they had some poll that was, you know, the WWE looked better in the poll, in my mind. Not in everything. You know, I mean, like, it was like the people kind of said that, you know, AEW had better matches and better crowds, which for sure they do. But WWE had better storylines, which it was like, what the fuck? I mean, other than, I mean, I grant you this Roman Reigns, Brock Lesnar, Paul Heyman storyline is very good. But most of them aren't. Most of them are not. You know, I mean, it's interesting, but even then, like the idea is that in this chart where they ask these people questions, I mean, even if WWE was 51% or 52% to 48%, it's still very competitive, and that's a, you know, that's a feather in the cap when you've been in the business for 2 years, and this company is the Coca-Cola of the industry, and in 2 years somebody comes in and is very competitive, not winning, Although there were metrics, you know, obviously in, you know, they won in house shows in September, and you know, in October they may, it's going to be closer. It was relatively close in August. They won, you know, AEW won big in September. October will probably be close. November, you know, we'll see how November goes. But they're very competitive in house shows. You know, I think in all the markets that both have run, I mean, WWE dominated Houston, Dallas, and Philadelphia, and everything else was close. And, you know, yeah, the other markets are all very close. And Cincinnati was a big AEW win. Chicago's a big AEW win, although Chicago's a good WWE city. New York, obviously a big, huge AEW win in New York, no doubt about it. And this coming up UBS Arena is a scary big AEW advantage right now, almost 3-1 ticket sales, which is just unbelievable in a market that's the WWE's main market that they've drawn the best in historically, you know, forever. So yeah, I mean, I expect more stories about competition. And if AEW does win Friday, and it is absolutely not a lock that they will, but if they do, I do expect that one to be jumped on, and I expect a lot of not just interest in the Friday rating, but you know, there's gonna be some people very, there's gonna be some people very, very happy, and there's gonna be some people not very happy. You know, more than usual, more than on Monday, because that's not head to head. This one's going to be a real life head to head, with the age, you know, their most popular show. Not their, I mean, really Raw's more popular, but SmackDown does get the most viewers on a traditional week because of the Fox platform and everything. And is usually the better show of the two also.
Hey, if you're a big fan of Wrestling Observer Radio, we got 12,000 episodes of all of our podcasts up at our website, WrestlingObserver.com. If you sign up today, you get access to every single one of them. The 12 to 18 new shows that we do every single week. You can podcast them, listen to them on the road, at work, working out, in the shower, wherever you listen to your podcasts. And also full access to the Wrestling Observer newsletter and archives. So if you love what you hear, head to WrestlingObserver.com. 12,000 audio shows at your fingertips.